Shop Talk, and I'm Ria Tanwatko Trillo. It smells really good here in the studio today, and that's because we have companies in the fragrance business. So if you're looking to start your own perfume or cologne business, then I'm sure you'll learn a lot from our guests today. Is it just about having the nose for the scents and the smell? Well, we'll find out. And first up, we have with us a brand that I grew up with, I'm sure you did too, and it's still very much in the market to this day. I'm talking about Angel's Breath, and here to tell us about how the brand has grown and evolved is Jesse Galvez. He is a spokesperson for Angel's Breath Philippines. Hello, Jesse, and thanks for coming on the show.
Hi, good evening. Thank you for inviting us.
Okay, now, Angel's Breath has been around since the late 80s, more
yeah,
or less.
Late 80s, early 90s. That's when it started, actually.
Okay, and it was started by your wife and your father-in-law.
It was started by my wife, Ampi Nepomuceno, and her father, Luis Nepomuceno of Nepomuceno Productions, no? It was actually because of some friends of the father from Spain who was kind of convincing the father to, why don't you try developing and selling some, the colognes, the scents, because they actually got the idea because one time my wife went on a trip to Europe and she brought home quite a lot of, these different scents. And I think from there, that's where they got the idea of doing that. And since my father had some Spanish friends, they were kind of telling him, why don't you start something like that? So Angel's Breath came from Spain. The essence is made in Spain. It's mixed there, and then it's shipped back here. And then here, it's mixed into different kinds of colognes already. But the pinaka essence is that Angel's Breath,
Okay, so the essence comes, and when it reaches the Philippines, you don't change the smell. You just make it into different concentrations depending on what product.
That's right.
Okay, but who actually put this wonderful scent together?
There's somebody in the plant. We have a plant who, chemist who does that.
But I mean,
using natural water, alcohol, no synthetic stuff.
Yeah, but the actual smell from Spain, is there a special person or group that came up with the Angel's Breath smell?
Actually, the smell of that was made specially for them in Spain, no? I guess what it really tried to do was to cater to a younger or fresher, like newer market of some kind,
Yeah, but I think the nice thing about Angel's Breath is that you have a whole range of people who like it. Some people like it on their babies, some students use it, mommies, lolas. I think there's something about it that really makes everyone just want to smell that way.
Yeah, yeah.
Right? And but when they first brought the scent in, did they have a specific market in mind?
Well, actually, when it first started, it was being sold to students in school. No, and the younger generation, but eventually it evolved because even the kids were kind of selling it to friends and stuff like that. And then eventually we tried marketing it to some outlets in the PX stores in Makati, and there's another one.
Cash and Carry,
yeah, right. that's the one, yes. And then from there it evolved, finally it was a lot of people started liking it until it went into the department stores.
Right, okay. And today, where can we find Angel's Breath?
Right now it's available in some outlets of Shumart, Robinson's, and Landmark, Trinoma, and Makati. And lately now, our latest development for it is we've tied up with a direct selling group. Mm-hmm. It's called Fashion Exchange. So that what we're going to do is to try to make it more available in the provinces.
Perfect.
Because our experience that a lot of people there, it's the accessibility, especially in the province.
I'm sure people are looking for it. And over the years, you guys have been able to expand your product line somewhat. It's not just colognes.
Yes.
Right?
Basically, from the same essence, so it's the same smell, we also have powder and the soap.
Okay, and actually, you guys also sell it in these cute little gift packs,
yes,
which I have right here. I'm going to open this, okay? All right. So you have here, what do you have? You have the powder, okay?
Yeah.
So this smells like the cologne.
Exactly the same scent, yes.
Okay, all right. And then this is the cologne itself.
Uh-huh.
And you also have the soaps.
It's actually a complete bath product.
Nice, nice, nice. And so if you're going to sell this, because I know you guys are in the bazaars a lot, like what's the price range usually of these gift packs?
The package gift packs is anywhere from 120 up.
120 up. Okay, so those are really good giveaways, right?
Yes, in fact, that's what a lot of people tell us when we do join the when we do it in the bazaars. It's actually for giveaways. It's easy. They just buy, you know.
And they don't have to. They don't have to package it anymore. Just write on the card, and
exactly.
and you're good to go. But you know, Angel's Breath having been around so long, how do you guys stay competitive and stay alive in the market?
Good question. I guess maybe it's because of we try to maintain the quality of the scents. And like I mentioned earlier, everything is that's used is natural, so that also it can be used, like you said earlier, even for kids or even for older people, no? So we try to tap not just a specific market, but, you know. That's right. Why if you notice in the one of the ads that we've come out with, it's more of for Lolas, for, you know, something like that.
For everyone. Mm-hmm. But you also say that the essences or the oils that are used in the essence of Angel's Breath are really top quality, and they're not the same as, like, the maybe synthetic essences that you
yes.
have. How could one actually tell the difference?
Good.
Because I think with Angel's Breath, the smell kind of stays the same, but for synthetic, either it doesn't last as long or the scent changes once it's on your skin for a while.
That's true. The reaction to the skin is quite different. No? That's one thing we have noticed about it. And I guess that's what people like.
Right, right. Okay, and so you mentioned that you will be doing a direct selling thing in the provinces.
Yes,
right?
And it was just launched, I think, a couple of weeks ago.
Okay, so it's already happening.
Yes.
Okay, nice. And you will be joining the bazaar circuit in the south, I believe?
Yes, we'll be joining two bazaars in Alabang starting November, December.
Right.
In fact, the ones that you see, the package ones, will only be available in the bazaars.
Okay.
The regular ones like that are going to be it's already available in Shoemart, like I said, and Landmark and Robinson's.
Right, but the gift packs are only available at the bazaar.
At the bazaars, yes.
Right, and of course, a lot of people think that Angel's Breath is just for just for the ladies and stuff. But you actually have a perfume for men.
Oh yeah, yeah. In fact, I use it myself. Now there is what you call home.
Mm-hmm.
And even like that yellow one, it's more of a lemony taste. It's also used by men.
Oh, okay. The yellow one. What's it called?
Angel Smile.
Angel Smile. Okay.
Yeah.
So you have Angel's Breath, Angel Smile,
and Angel's Love.
And Angel's
the
Love.
The Love is more of a rosy scent. It's really for women, because actually Angel's Breath, it can go either way. It can be for men or for women.
I see.
Now the limes is more lemony. Is more for the men, really, and the rose is for the women.
Oh, okay. So really like something for everyone. Okay. What the advice do you have, or what the nuggets of wisdom, having been in this business for so long, what do you have to tell those who are considering doing the same thing?
Well, I guess to just try to make a good product at the end of the day, because it's really up to the people who will either like it or not. But what's important is, well, be natural about it.
Right. And the thing with perfume is, you know, it's for some people it might be a necessity, but for other people it's actually a luxury.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So what do you do, say, in tough times when a lot of people consider perfume a luxury?
Yeah, that's true, because it depends on the times, no?
Mm-hmm.
Well,
Or you sort of just accept it as part of the cycle of the business?
Yeah, yeah. I guess you could say that, because there's really what you call the ups and downs about it.
Right. Okay, always innovating. And you guys will be at the St. James Bazaar November 26th or 30th, and the Zonta Christmas Bazaar December 17th to 18th. Oh, and before we go, I need to ask you, if people out there, our viewers, want to be direct sellers, how do they go about it?
I have the numbers, so they can call.
We'll put it on the screen.
Yeah.
All right, excellent. Jesse Galvez, thank you so much for coming on Shop Talk.
Thank you very much for inviting me.
All right, well, we're taking a very short break now. Keep it here. Shop Talk will be right back.